Hey everyone, it's Brett, Top Shelf Collectibles. I'm going through some of my duplicate, triplicate, quadruples, whatever you want to call them all. And here's one that's going out. Iggy and the Stooges, Raw Power. So I'm just kind of doing a quick little filming of it so everyone can see what it looks like. Still in the shrink. Has a little bit of a tear right here, but got the Raw Power sticker there, price tag from a long time ago, and let me pull the inner sleeve out and pull the record out. All right, back on the other side, here is the printed inner sleeve from Columbia, just basically the picture of Iggy, both sides there, and then you can see a little reflection in the lights there, but this is a really, really nice copy. A few, you can't quite see if a little sleeve scuffs, probably from when it was first purchased. People weren't putting stuff into MoFi or whatever anti-static sleeve you use. But yeah, I'll do a quick little sound test of this puppy. Hold on. All right, I'm back. Gonna do a quick, I'll try to keep it like under 15 seconds. There was 20, because I don't want to get dinged by YouTube. Yeah, so really, really clean record, except besides the a few sleeve scuffs, mostly light marks. But yeah, this is a great copy that plays through perfectly, and will be a great addition to anyone's collection. So it's going to be on Discogs. All right, hey, thanks. Enjoy the day. All right, the Iggy album sold already. It was really quick, so I just thought I'd show again how I package up my stuff, especially the higher end records. So, cardboard, bubble wrap, record. With the record out of the package, in an inner sleeve, turned sideways so it can't come flying out. Bubble wrap, cardboard on top again. I'll close this up. And then it's going to go into a 14 by 14 by 4 larger box for safe shipping. I'll show you the end product. Okay, so after I got the record into the box, that's what I do most, you know, most records get every record gets the double cardboard, double bubble wrap, and then put into a white mailer, taped up. On the outside will be a do not crush, do not fold. Blocking my light. Man, I need to become a professional. And then a please handle, you know, fragile sticker goes on there. But records, usually the records that are $300 or more, I will put into double box like this, just because I want them to get there safe, secure, and in the condition that the buyer is expecting. You know, I'm a huge collector of high-end records, and I understand what it is to get records that are not what you thought they're going to be. So I really want everything that I sell to show that I care and that I'm trying hard to get it to you, unless the post office damaged it. And I've had that twice on some mobile fidelity records. The post office just destroyed the boxes and covers ended up getting dinged. The vinyl itself was still fine, but the covers had some dings, so I did take them back. Yeah. You can see my feedback on Discogs. I feel like I got a lot of really good feedback on how well I do protect my stuff. So anyways, this will now get protection on top, closed up, and shipped off. All right. Hey, thanks for listening to me, and everyone enjoy some music out there. Thanks again. Bye.